Okay, so me and my wife Rebecca and local developers Shay Pierce and Jocelyn Reyes were here. And our LA-based art director Heather Penn have been working on a game called Overland, which is playable here tonight. And I just wanted to talk to you guys really quick a little bit about some of our inspirations and ideas. One of our inspirations for Overland is a book by the Strugatsky brothers called Roadside Picnic, which is usually best known for being the source material for a Tarkovsky film called Stalker, which is sort of a wonderful, amazing movie, but also actually very different from the book. The book is kind of all about like bar fights in the black market and like the mafia. And it's just kind of, it's really interesting because it's, the idea that aliens came and it was a big apocalyptic event, but people are still people, is kind of this optimistic, interesting idea to me. We're also really inspired by a game called Kentucky Route Zero, because it's the best game ever made. Those guys came back from the future, in which everyone already figured out how to make games really work well, and are showing us how to do it through Kentucky Route Zero. So I definitely recommend that. There's a game called 868 Hack by a guy named Michael Bro, that's a very inspirational kind of puzzle roguelike type of game and that I really like because it takes place in a very small space. The game board is about 6x6 squares, and there's a lot, it's very dense, even though your interactions are very simple. And I really like this game, XCOM, sort of squad-based, high stakes, interesting decisions, kind of a 3D space, and you've got multiple people to keep track of. We're really inspired by our art director specifically is bringing a lot of weird influences like Edward Hopper and biomorphic abstraction, and I'm bringing my own obsession with coral reefs being super gross, and coral reefs are totally disgusting. But the basic idea is we're trying to create kind of a slightly different kind of apocalypse, so not the same kind of apocalypse that's in The Road or in Fallout or Wasteland or things like that. We want it to be kind of weird and lonely and dangerous and beautiful in spite of itself. As far as gameplay things go, specifically, I like this because this in Overland is like a really handy thing to find. If you find a wood stick, you're like, okay, I can do something with this. This is great. And I like that because it's simple, it's a normal thing that you recognize from life, it's easy to understand what it is and what it's, as a game designer, we would say what its affordances are, what are the things that it can do that are interesting. A lot of things in Overland are randomly generated, so the terrain itself is not randomly generated, but the way in which everything is arranged in the level and the sequence in which the levels go and the highway that you travel down are randomly generated every time that you play. This is, I think, awesome, but it's also very tricky. Randomly generated things can feel very samey or soupy, or everything's randomized in the same way, so even though it's random, it doesn't really matter. It can sometimes feel very unfair. You go, oh, the level started, and it's extra shitty for me. So we have a couple of rules that we use to try and moderate this. This is from a game called Minotaur China Shop, which is about a Minotaur in a China shop. He actually owns and runs the China shop, which is kind of sad. But one of our rules for randomness in Overland is to actually have as many things as possible not be random, and instead be the difficult to predict consequences of your own actions. And so the idea of a Minotaur in a China shop for me is you have this big room full of very fragile things that are very carefully organized. You can walk in and see how all those things are put together. But if you were to walk in there as a Minotaur and start knocking things over and tables falling to tables, it's really hard to predict exactly what the ruined shop is going to look like. So it's not exactly random, it's kind of deterministic, but it's so hard to predict that it might as well be random, but it has this extra flavor of everything being your fault. And that's kind of interesting, I think. But you still need some random elements. Not everything can be deterministic like this. And so when you do have random elements, it seems to help a lot, help this perception of unfairness if you are given a proportional warning. And so if something really bad is gonna happen to you, you get a warning from really far away, like, hey, this terrible thing is coming. And if it's something smaller and less important, maybe you don't get as much warning. So, wait, where did that slide come from? Is that yours, Brandon?
Yes.
That's a creepy barn. Oh, I guess that's about it. I think that's all I have. So yeah, enjoy the game. We've got a station down here and a station up there, and we have some stickers and pins over here on the table. If you see Shay and Jocelyn around in the crowd, say hi and congratulations for making such a cool game. I get to say that because there's so many other people doing awesome work on this. Yeah, that's it. All right.
Oh,
it comes out this summer. Yeah. Huh? Should we have questions? Do people have questions? People can shout questions if they want.
How do you win?
Right now, if you make it through the same first set of 15 levels that have been copy-pasted 4 times to stress test the way that you emerge from regions, a screen pops up that says, like, yay, good job, and then there's like an ASCII heart shape. Yeah, your goal is to collect fuel and try not to run out of gas and get stranded in places you really don't want to be stranded, and not have everyone die, because if they do, that's it. Yeah.
What kills you?
Things. Most of the things. You can accidentally run over your own teammates. You can die in a fire. There are things that kind of come up from the ground that do not want you here anymore, and they will do you in. Most of the things.
Where are you trying to go?
West.
Why?
I don't want to talk about it right now. It's complicated. If you find one. Sometimes you can find the remains of an animal shelter, and you can get we have to put vans in, but as soon as you have a van, you should be able to travel with it up to 5 dogs. We're trying to have a really good ceiling for maximum number of dogs. Also, if you tonight find a dog that can talk, just ignore it. It's fine.
What are you building it in?
We are building it in Unity, which so far is pretty interesting and mostly good. All right. Well, have fun, and thanks for coming out. Really appreciate it.